or wherever. I didn't have anything to do. Boys had put the risers out on the stage. The piano was pulled out. Somebody had warmed the choir up. And all I had to do was just go down there, go to the stage and get the downbeat. They were ready. But you don't find the kind of dedication and the responsibility and the love for one another that I found here at Caddo Parish High School. You know, I appreciate this so much that I can't even find the words to say to you what this has really meant to me. And whoever organized this, I thank you so much. Choir, I cannot believe y'all still sound that beauty. And now I'm trying to figure out how we can put y'all on the road. Somebody else needs to hear you all. You all were good. You all were just great. And I was sitting there looking at the techniques that they learned, and mouths were open, nobody was handshaking. And when y'all got ready to sing, I think that was Carla back there, said, they didn't warm up. I said, maybe they warmed up another time, but that's all right. You all were so good. I really appreciate you. And I just don't know how to say thank you. This has meant so much to me. And you know, Kim really kept this a secret. And she kept. And I kept asking her every day, I said, Kim, you sure I'm not the only one? Oh no, all the teachers. So I called Miss Hines. But just so happened I didn't get Miss Hines. I left a message on her phone. I said, Miss Hines, I said, Kim been seeing some things on Facebook that they're gonna honor the teachers at Caddo Parish. And are you going Saturday morning at 10:30? But Miss Hines never did call back, so I don't know if she got the message or not. And then I had thought about calling Miss Cleveland, who lives in Minden with me, but I never got around to calling Miss Cleveland. I never got around to calling her. But this was such a surprise this morning. Such a surprise. And you just don't know. It's just heavy on my heart. You know, I'm surprised I'm not boohooing right now, but I cried enough to take it. But thank you all so much. I love you all so much, every one of you. Every one of you. And, you know, I wish that one day we could get together and make a CD, because you all, I'm thinking like Carl, now I'm thinking big time. I am thinking big time. And it's so good seeing you all, and you know, when you get, somebody told me they were 50, so that's pushing me on up there. But, you know, it's just a blessing. It's a blessing. It is a blessing to be the age that we are. And every year you get a little older, I get a little older. Praise God. I'm not staying down there where I used to be. And you know, and I just thank y'all for being such good students back there today. You know, we went a lot of places where you all could really show them out. And I have never in my life heard of this, but we took a bus to Canada. I don't know who was in here during that time, but we went all the way to Canada on some chartered buses. And everybody asked, now how did you all go to Canada on chartered buses? But we went and we were feeling good about it. But I think it took us 3 or 4 days to get there. But we got there. And we have that in our memories. New York was such a wonderful time. And you know, and I had such a wonderful time with the parents of your parents. And I would tell their parents, I might have to send someone back home COD. And y'all believe it too. Because somebody in here right today showed out in New York. And I stopped and wants to send him back COD. But I'm not going to call any names. And Mr. Price used to tell me, say, Miss Howell, Miss Britton, some of the boys you got in choir, I guess those were the cars that I plucked out of the school. He said, they stand up there and look like angels with the bow ties on. Hey, that's some bad boys. What are you doing with them? I said, well, they just in there learning. And the parents were so wonderful. You know, parents would call me and Some of them would even tell me a problem they were having within their homes. I said, I'm not a counselor, but I would even try to talk to them. And I guess that's the reason that when I see my parents today, I still remember the days that I was here and they were parents who would come out and support us. I just can't think of much more I could say except thank you all so much. Thank you all for the memories.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. You never know what impact you have on people's lives until they let you know. And you know, we have people in this choir have gone, I mean, so many different careers. I mean, we got attorneys, judges, lawyers, doctors, teachers, preachers. I mean, you can just go on. Filmmakers. We have some of everything here in this choir. And I wish one day we could get back together and just sing to the glory of God. When Ellen got up and sang a few minutes ago, Kim always remembers what Ellen sang at our first gospel concert. One more Sunday. And we still remember that. And Sheila is still moving down that like she normally does. Malik, they are so good. Felicia out there directing. And you know, these were students who would say, for instance, if we were in the choir room getting ready for rehearsal, I didn't have to worry about warming the choir room.
We never had a sub.
Thank you, Sharon. But let me tell you about one day I was absent. And I taught piano over there and choir down here. Do you know it was 12 o'clock noon when Ms. Smith realized that I didn't know it? And she said, Patricia, you weren't here yesterday? I said, no, ma'am. And somebody told me it was 12 o'clock at noon when they realized that you all didn't have a sub. Y'all went right on just like I was in there. Went right on. Warmed the choir up, had a rehearsal. Took the role. I've never seen something. But I'm truly blessed. I thank the Lord that He let me come this way and come in contact with people like you. I never forget you. I will never, never, ever forget you. And before I sit down, let me introduce my husband. When I was here, I was Patricia Britton. That was Kim's dad, and he passed away in 1999. And then I got married again, and the Lord sent me a good husband. And that's Paul Paul. So we've been married now 15 years going on, and he's such a wonderful husband. And everybody remembers Kim. Kim sounds like they'll see you again. And she has two children now, Brianna, who's 21. Young boy, y'all make me old. 21, and she has a 7-year-old. And that's why I'm so tired this morning, because that 7-year-old kept me up all night. All night with me. So that's why I'm still asleep from last night. He stayed there, but I love my grandchildren. Like somebody else was showing me their grandchildren, Miss Bradley, a few minutes ago. But again, thank you all. I love you, love you, I 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 love you. Thanks for doing it so much. Thanks for doing this, taking out your time to do this for me.
All right.
Woo-hoo!
Volunteers. I guess it's really okay.